guys! Welcome to Moving On TV. I haven't done something for quite a while. I thought I'd do something today because of all the Brexit and everything that's happening. So today I just want to put a positive eye on Brexit and what's happening. So let me put it this way. Brexit is just a symptom. Brexit is just one part of a disgusting, rotten, corrupt system that is collapsing bit by bit all over the world. You just have to watch it. It's like dominoes, like the old guard is going. And it's a very, very exciting time to be alive. Now, if you watch the media, if you watch the news, then all the fear-mongering is going to tell you that it's terrible what's happening, that we're going to go through hell, that, you know, everything's going to be awful. And what I'm going to tell you is actually I'm looking at every part of our lives at the moment as human beings here on this planet and how I believe that this is actually going to be a good thing. So welcome to Moving On TV and goodbye the EU. Let me start by saying that to me the EU was the Fourth Reich. So we were going to end up, I believe, with a one world army where your kids would have to be conscripted into the army. Now, I went into the army when I was young for 2 years and I don't wish that on anyone. We were going to have a one world army. We were going to have a one world anthem. And we know exactly where this was leading, to be taken over by the Fourth Reich. You wouldn't have a say in the matter. You know, I also did a bit of a study of the EU when I was studying the law a little bit. And I remember studying that all these countries would have to decide for me. Like, if I wanted the NHS, I couldn't make that decision. All these countries would have made that decision for me. That's no way to live. You know, I want to be independent. So anyway, let me tell you how I feel Brexit is going to be good for us. It's a symptom and it's the part of the fall of this awful system. Okay, let's take food, for example. People are panicking. The media is telling us we're not going to have any food. That's just total rubbish. The reason this is total rubbish is, first of all, there are other countries that are not in the EU. Okay, think about Israel, for example. They're the biggest production of fruit, amazing avocados, vegetables, fruit, all sorts of stuff. We do get a lot of food from Israel. We'll just keep getting food from Israel, okay? What about America? You know, people will be able to get food from America. Because I expect we'll have good relations with America after this. And all the other countries that are dropping out of the EU, we're all going to come together. Mankind, humanity, we're all going to come together. We will all be supporting each other. You know, the other thing, if you really want to, is, and I'm going to put some more stuff about this, is grow your own food. Start to learn how to grow your own fruit, your own vegetables, things like that. And if you think that maybe food isn't going to be plentiful for a while, then make sure you stock up on tins of food, rice, potatoes. You know, I grew up in Israel, grew up in wars, and I was in air raid shelters and we used to have bonfires where you would put potatoes on the bonfire. You know what I mean? And you could cook on a bonfire. So make sure you have matches. Make sure that you have, you know, things are that important to keep you going. If you do need them, it's nothing to be frightened of. I think it's a great experience. We're all going to come together. Communities, we're all going to work together to support each other to survive. That's how I see it. Now, if we go to medication, so again, tongue in cheek, as far as I'm concerned, if there's no medication, then people have to learn how to make themselves well. And God knows there are books out there, there is a huge amount of information. Medication is making you sick, okay? Not well. Side effects and everything. But again, you know, I'm not going to be general about this. Everybody knows that I talk about misdiagnosis and stuff like that. To me, it's an opportunity for people to wake up and understand that you can heal yourself. You don't need all of this medication. Anyway, there's going to be a huge amount left over. It's going to take ages for that medication to go. It's all fear-mongering, guys, and you need to not buy into it. When I left the hospital after I broke my leg, I was given tons and tons of morphine and Nurofen, God knows what. Masses of it. There is masses of it. I'm sure that, you know, there's going to be a lot of medication left there. So I don't think you need to worry about that so much. I personally don't think you need to worry about it. But as I say, when you come down to the nitty gritty, we can live without milk because dairy is not always good for us. Make sure you have enough water in your house. Bottles of water, stack them up, get pet food because you don't want your animals to suffer. It could happen. You know, I'm not fear-mongering, but we may need to get back into communities. What if we can't use our cars? Well, if you get enough petrol, you'll be able to use your car for a little while to help you settle. But what if you can't use your cars? Well, we survived. And what did we do? We had horse and carts. We have legs, you know. We'll make sure that we, you know, make sure you start to build relationships with your neighbors because you're going to need each other. Communities are going to need each other. You know, things like that. I hope me telling you this is going to help a little bit. Take away from some of the fear-mongering that's going on out there. What else did I think about? Because I've been talking to people about this. How would we survive if everything stops? Say we, like for example, our power. Where do you get your power from, your electricity? Usually from Norway? Norway's not even in the EU, so you don't have to worry about that. Where do you get your petrol from, actually? Petrol usually comes from Arab countries and also Texas, places like that. The chances are you will have good people that will provide you with petrol. I don't think it's anything to be frightened of. I think this is a wonderful opportunity for humankind to come together. I can't wait for celebrity cultures to disappear so we can all work again. I can't wait for the media to disappear so we can get a truth media telling us the truth that we don't hate each other and we don't want to kill each other. And a real truth media that investigates and looks into everything and educates us to be happy and not frightened and scared. I can't wait for a lot of people to go back to their countries because their country, they're not real refugees, with all due respect. You know, my family were Jews who ran away and they came to the country because they were being murdered. And for people like us that are paying £900 a month or £1,000 a month for one bedroom, it's going to be heaven for you and I, for people like us, because estate agents are not going to be able to keep their prices really high. You're not going to have people telling you you can't rent because of your pets, because they'll be desperate to give you houses. Houses will be standing empty. So that's exciting, isn't it? It's exciting. It's going to become a more equal society where people that have nothing and people that have everything won't exist. It will become more balanced. But we all have what we need. Money might go. Great. Let's barter. Bartering is exciting because we all have something to offer. Money is, when it's used in the wrong way, it's sex trafficking children. Sex trafficking children's gonna go. They won't be able to do it anymore because money won't mean anything to them. Everything is coming up, guys. Everything. The royal family are gonna go. And all the lies and the deceit and the paedophilia and everything's coming up. Everything. They're going to stop the chemtrails, the geoengineering. They won't be able to control our weather because we are waking up. Okay? And so Brexit is just one part of this. One incredible part. You know what I'm excited about? Okay, we may not have phones, we may not have mobiles, we may not have the internet. I'm excited about getting those machines where you can communicate it with each other like we used to do. Well, we didn't. People in the war did. Learning Morse code, learning to talk to people again, going to my neighbors, having coffee, making relationships with, creating relationships with our neighbors. Become a leader in your community. If you want to find out more, contact me, or you can join the party also that I'm involved in, the TPRP party, the Truth, the People's Revolution Party. The People's Revolution Party. We're full of compassion. We're coming together to create equality, to end this. But even if things do go a bit pear-shaped, get 6 months worth of food in your house, drink. And this is not fear-mongering, this is exciting. I'm exciting. I'm excited to be a powerful human with feelings and emotions coming together with the human race against something that has enslaved us for too long now. So if you watch this, and you understand what I'm saying, you're not a slave, guys. You're not a slave. We don't have to go to war. We don't have to fight anyone. We can communicate here, or we can get to know each other. Direct Activity Center in Burnham, connect with people, meditate together, figure out ways how you're going to be able to go to people like hubs of positivity. And if you can't move to places like that, then create a hub of positivity in your own town, in your own area. So that's all I'm saying. This is the positive side of what's coming. Nothing to fear. Stop watching the media. Watch the truth. Watch the truth. Watch Q. Watch Jordan Sather. Watch Deception Bite. Watch Simon Parks. There's so many of them. Great people out there that are bringing you the truth. The truth. And the old system is collapsing to give us a wonderful new way. I will be able to earn a living singing if we barter. I will sing for my supper. Martin will do hypnotherapy for his supper. So take care of yourselves, guys. I grew up in wars. We are on alert. Anything could happen, and it's not to be frightened. Communicate with each other. I'm going to create a group, protect each other through the snow. The snow will be inverted brackets. It means, you know what I mean. If this happens, you need to know what to do. You need to know how to grow your own food. You need to know what to eat. You know to know what to wear. I'm a bit scared about not having any heating, so I've got to get past that. So I've got to have loads of clothes, and I'm going to learn everything I can about how to be stronger. You need to learn this. You need to come together in your communities. There will be more groups popping up all over the place. We'll be able to join together to make our world a better place. Make England great again. Mega. But not just England. All the countries are throwing out the old and taking on the beauty, the pure, what it is to be a human. We are not robots. We love. We love from the heart. No one will hurt our children again. No one will take our children and sell them again. No one will abort our babies at 9 months. No one will stick poison from vaccinations into our children. It's all going to end. Do what the wonderful mother I met. She took her child to be vaccinated and she said to the nurse, "Can you please tell me one ingredient in this and I let my child be vaccinated?" The nurse knew nothing, so she took her kids away. I have never vaccinated my cats. They're the healthiest cats around. The children that I know that have not been vaccinated have no issues whatsoever. No allergies, no ADHD, no autism, no nothing. Learn the truth, guys. Question everything. Are we a globe? Are we flat earth? Flat earth. Are we a globe? Are we flat earth? Question everything. Talk to your friends, your relations. Have wonderful conversations like I had with my husband today. But be on alert. We can come together and we can have a wonderful Brexit. I love you lots, and please share.
The thoughts I have of you, you're always on my mind. Circling, circling round my brain, it happens all the time. I close my eyes and a vision will appear. Wish that